Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines. I hope you had a blessed holiday season. We're still coming up on New Year's, they call it. You know, I'm just laughing to myself because every year I go through the same thing. I was just thinking of last year, someone had messaged me when I made a video for New Year's Eve, and someone said, "Oh, you're following the pagan calendar." No, everyone in the world is knows that they're calling it a new year. It's called the year of our Lord, A.D. is the Latin phrase, which means year of our Lord. 2014 is where we're coming on. So that year, that calendar was started, supposed to be a reference to the year since the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ. So I don't consider it a pagan calendar because it's pegged off of the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God for that. And even Christmas, every year I make a video about this. I didn't do it this year because it's becoming mundane. But I used, when I first got filled with the Spirit and first started walking with the Lord, I said, "Hey, I'm not going to have any kind of anything to do with Christmas celebration." I prayed about it. I fasted about it and prayed about it and sought the Lord. And the Lord just spoke to me and showed me, brothers and sisters, that the whole world knows about the virgin birth of Jesus Christ because of the Christmas holiday. No, Jesus wasn't born December 25th. No, it was a made-up holiday, and it was grafted off the back of pagan celebrations. That's all true, brothers and sisters. Most of the elements of the Christmas celebration came from pagan origins, from different parts of the world, from Finland, the god Yule, and all this kind of stuff. But everyone in the world today knows about the virgin birth of the Son of God because of that holiday. So instead of being a killjoy, instead of being full of urine and vinegar, get out there and show love. Jesus said, "God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son." We have to demonstrate, take advantage of every situation, not to do. Now let me say this. Any of you who watch these videos that are, you know, historical videos, documentaries about the origin of Christmas, you will see that the Catholic Church used these pagan holidays to do what? To advance their kingdom, to advance their church, to advance Roman Catholicism. Okay, we're not doing that. We're using it to advance the kingdom of God, to evangelize people, to win them to the Lord Jesus Christ. Hey, December 25th is a reminder. Jesus was born of a virgin. He's the only begotten Son of God. He was born in a manger. He's the only begotten of the Father. That's the message that we need to promote, to grow and advance the kingdom of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the purpose that we have to do with Christmas. We can't go out here as an individual and stop a worldwide, basically, almost every country in the world celebrates this holiday in reference to the birth of Christ. We're not on a campaign to negatively go out and attack a pagan holiday. God never said go out and, you know, and be an evangelist against a pagan holiday. Jesus said, go into all the world and make disciples of the nations. We're supposed to preach the gospel to every creature. And then the Lord's coming back for his people. That's what we've been commanded to do, to give the new good news, not the bad news. Like I've mentioned in my videos before, and the Lord keeps leading me to say, the people on YouTube are doing all these breaking news headlines and all that. They're giving the bad news of the world. Half of it is a bunch of rumors and innuendos that ends up being nothing anyway. This world is passing away, Jesus said. This age, when Jesus talked about the world, he's talking about this age, the age of man, the age of Satan as the god of this world. This age is passing away. All those things are going to fail. Every human, all those people are going to be dead and no longer in power. Obama's in power today. He'll be gone tomorrow. Bush was in power before. He's gone. All those former presidents and all those things, the big headlines on the news, they come and go. But Jesus' gospel is always the same. God's steadfast love was manifested, came into this world. Love of God broke through into this third dimensional world that we live in, within the fourth dimension, I guess, really, a space-time continuum, to quote the doc from Back to the Future. God broke through the space-time continuum into this dimension where we live and came and lived among us, and we beheld his glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen. That was the John chapter 1, the Lord Jesus Christ. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. And it tells us the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And to those who believe on His name, who those who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, to them the Lord Jesus gives power to become children of God. Behold, what manner of love is this? That God would send His only begotten Son into the world to die on the cross for us. Now the Christmas holiday season tells us, the whole world, Jesus was born of a virgin in a manger. All the little kids know that story, that He was born in a manger because of Christmas. Easter, I don't care about Ishtar. I didn't come to preach against Ishtar. I came to say that at the Passover season for the Jews, the Jewish holiday, as John told us, a feast of the Jews is Passover. From the Old Testament, the angel of death passed over the children of Israel who had the blood of the Lamb over the doorposts of their home. The Lamb without spot or without blemish. Now our Lord Jesus Christ died. As a matter of fact, He was put on the cross at 9 a.m. Talking about Easter. He was put on the cross at 9 a.m. The third hour in the King James is 9 a.m. in the morning. The time of the morning sacrifice in the temple on Passover. And then He gave up the ghost at 3 p.m., the ninth hour, at the time of the evening sacrifice in the temple at Jerusalem. He was put on the cross at the first sacrifice, so that they have two sacrifices, the morning and evening sacrifice. He gave up the ghost at the evening sacrifice on the day of Passover. He is our Passover Lamb, fulfilling a shadow of the very thing to come, the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ Himself. And the whole world knows that, and that He resurrected on the Feast of First Fruits, the first day of the week, a.k.a. in our calendar, Sunday morning, the Lord Jesus Christ came out of the grave. On what people call Easter Sunday, everybody in the world knows that that holiday is not, they don't know about no Ishtar. They know that it's the day that Jesus is supposed to have resurrected because of that pagan name holiday that people have, you know, added as tradition to the Word of God. But people know it because of that. We have to, by all means, as Paul said, become all things to all people. And as I said, the bottom of this, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, without love I am nothing. Without love I am nothing. Without love I am nothing. There are people on YouTube who spew hate and attack everybody all the time, attack people. They don't know what's love. Love is God gave His only begotten Son, for God so loved the world, that He demonstrated His love toward us, the Bible says. While we were yet sinners, He died for us. How about that? While you were still living in sin, while you were still lost and without hope in this world, while you were lying, cheating, stealing, committing adultery, fornication, doing drugs, drunk, whatever you was doing, Jesus had already died for you. That's love. That's love. That's love. Brothers and sisters, I got more videos to make. Let me pause this one. I'm going to label this one Christmas holiday celebration. We're called to preach the good news of Jesus Christ and exploit all things, become all things to all people, and not to advance our own kingdom. As I said, it was originally started by Roman Catholicism to advance Roman Catholicism. But we are using it not to mix doctrines, not to bring leaven, but to use it to speak truth in love that Jesus was born of a virgin, which is honored, celebrated, recognized, and known about because of the made-up birthday of December 25th, a.k.a. Christmas. So Merry Christmas to you. Merry remembrance of the virgin birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May God use you to advance His kingdom in this day. And on New Year's, tell everybody what A.D. means. Anno Deum. Look it up. The year of our Lord. And use that to exploit the fact that our calendar was changed because of the birth of one man. Buddha didn't change the calendar. All these other people didn't change the calendar. Jesus Christ changed the calendar that's recognized in the whole world. God bless you guys.